They play plucked instruments such as mandolin, banjo, bouzouki, mandola, guitar.
I play the flute and I'm singing, and I also play the hurdy-gurdy and my feet.
We were both buskers. I was a full-time busker.
I met him at a session and I was looking for someone else to go busking with. Back then I was busking every day and I would have been always dancing with live music, so I was looking for some, you know, good stable player, which he is.
We just said it'd be nice, you know, play a few tunes together for the crack, have a busk together. The response by the audience was great, and we kind of wanted to immortalize that moment, you know, that particular show.
In the end of last year, before he was leaving, he came up with an idea that we could record an album when he comes back, and then COVID happened and he didn't come back, but we applied for the COVID response award and we ended up getting it. So then, even though he is in Rome and I'm here, but he managed to come here and we recorded the album. I was learning some old steps from the Traveling Dance Master era, and then Emanuele likes digging into old recordings, and I think he just came up with this concept and I thought, yeah, this is great. I just thought it would be perfect. And also that era is very much connected with like dancing and music in a duo settings, because you would have the Traveling Dance Masters traveling around, and some of them had their musician, like their own musician who would have traveled with them. So we kind of thought that would be an interesting similar thing to do.
What if we got back to that kind of way to playing music? What we try to do in the album is trying to recreate that atmosphere, but it cannot be said that it's a philological precise reconstruction. It is rather a suggestion.
We were deciding whether we're gonna record the album in a studio entirely, or whether we're gonna do the course of the tracks live.
So then Emanuele called me, asked me if I could record a project and explain me everything about it. And I thought we could record here in the studio, but I remember that Aneta used to teach dance in the Katie's Glada cottage, and it super suits the project. That lovely place, that lovely environment to bring those two great musicians to play live there. And so that's what I proposed to them, and they loved it.
The place just has a really good atmosphere, and I feel really comfortable dancing in there, and I like bringing people in there, and it's really beautiful inside. And the owner, Mike Walsh, he supports local artists and he loves traditional music and dance, so I thought it would be really nice to do the recording here.
I think inspiring is the word that describes it better. It was just great to stay in such a charming room.
We have a guest on the album. Her name is Fionnuala Hannigan-Dunkley, and Fionnuala is a concertina player and singer. Met Fionnuala pretty much the second day after arriving to Galway in October 2015, and I've been playing music and dancing to her music since then. So she's going to be playing concertina on a few tracks, and also she's going to be lilting. We're here in the Clodagh, and the Clodagh was a fishing village. And there is a connection between the thatched cottages and the Travelling Dance Master era. So obviously these houses were homes for people, and back in the day the music and the dancing would happen at home, really, or outside, and it served the people for their entertainment, for people to meet and communicate in a different way. And I guess that for us, for me and Emanuele, the music and the dancing serves in a similar way, really. And when we play the music, it really is about communication and connecting in a different way.
Aneta would suggest me some musical ideas and accents and would there...
A conversation between the two of us. So, you know, we listen to each other and we respond to each other in our own ways through dancing or through music.
I really wish that we can get back to the audience that feeling, you know, that kind of live, almost absolutely improvised kind of imprinting, you know.
I definitely think that the settings of the Katies helped with the atmosphere, and we're trying to recreate the atmosphere of the traveling dance master era. And so hopefully that will be heard, we will be able to hear it on the recording.